Oh my God, I'm giant. Let me fix that. Let me fix that. Anyways, because I just disappeared from existence because guess who decided to mess with all of their video screens all of a sudden because I'm like, this is gonna be cute. No, because then I had to readjust everything. Oh, the little stretch. Anyways, I put the new batteries in this, which is it's very small. Look at it. Which now I get to hear it. Beautiful, excellent. Still have yet to find like another copy of these ever. Bought these through eBay. Back in 2007, 2015, I cannot remember because I don't have my eBay page anymore, so it's lost in the abyss of nothingness. But at least I have them and they work, so we're good. You're here to continue with the last door, which. How many episodes? I mean, we've gone through technically a prologue bit. Episode one, episode two, which episode two just went all over the place. Necrophilia, crazy mental end of life term care, priests who literally would burn themselves on fire. Little crazy, little crazy. I mean, there was so much more. I mean, the very fact of the end, spoiler. Were literally buried alive, so that's hella concerning. Beginning to edge into the story of how the heck we're going to suddenly bury ourselves, so get ready for that. Oh, one cool note that I did get. Yeah! I got the little flippy phone! Woohoo! Plus, I mean, I still have like a bazillion of these little fruits basket stickers from the original manga collection when it finished up. So I was like, you know what? Let me put some of the stickers in there, which 90% of this isn't covered in Toru Honda stickers. I mean, there is Yuki and Kyo on here, but they're mostly in their cat and rat form, but still. It's cute. I love it. It's nostalgia for me, and I get to be like, hello. You're awake! Good morning. Oh, she just drooled on me. Drink the water. I mean, I already have this water, but more liquids. But I'm drinking it. Continue forth. Preface all that. Let us begin. The last. Oh, is it doing us a flashback? Oh, it is doing us a flashback. Wait, is it? Unless it didn't save, but anyways, enjoy the music.
Even after all these years, I've not forgotten your voice. You are the fourth witness.
I remember. I remember now what happened. What it is we saw. And if anything, maybe this plot is actually going into Eldridge gods, potentially? I mean, it does kind of span into the gothic horror era. The eye of the bird.
Malin said.
What happened to us? What is it that we witnessed? You must tell me. You must make me understand what my mind cannot fathom.
Die at the bird.
It was our curiosity that damned us. We opened that which should never be opened. In doing so, we shone the veil that separated our world from his. In seeking vision, we ourselves were seen by the eye of the bird. It remembers us. It looks for us. It calls us from its dark nest, from its abominable cavity. Abominable lair. All these years I've left. Dude, Brain, could you read? In all these years I have attempted to return to it, but I have no strength left. These poor, wretched creatures are too fragile. They lack the sight to return. Not one of them has. Only us, the four witnesses. Who are the other two? Where are they? They disappeared as you did. I haven't heard from any of you. I was seized by curiosity. It absconded me with faith and deprived me of sanity. Oh, Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned. Nothing remains. All that is left is surrender to him. Grave, have we sinned, and now our only absolution is to burn in the flames. And there's the priest.
Oh, man.
And there's the necrophilia dude. And he just pops us in the head. Sounds of us being buried alive again. Let me out. I mean, maybe we have a pen or something. We can at least jam open the screws, but we're under dirt. Throwing dirt. Oh, he's shoveling us in. Claustrophobia. Fantastic. I just wanted some dirt in the breakfast. Ah, see? Shovel in the dirt. We're somehow underneath that. How the fuck we get out? But didn't I finish this last time? Did it not save me? The adventure continues in episode 3, which is The Four Witnesses, though. Now I'm noting, it's kind of weird that it's Four Witnesses in episode 3 when they could have done that title for episode 4. It just would have fit better, number-wise, but that's my only little quip on that. Adventure! Previously on The Last Door. After the death of his old friend, Anthony, Yvette decided to travel back to the school they had both attended to in the outskirts of Aberdeen. In a search, Yvette met his old teacher, Father Ernest. He also remembers the experiments they'd all attempted many years back, which had terrible consequences.
Yeah, no shit.
In truth is revealed, Father Ernest worships the eye of the bird, the vision resulting from the experiment. He killed many people trying to replicate its results. Oh, wow, he was a man of the word, and he decided to murder. Religion. Those who saw the eye back then, he calls the Four Witnesses, then discovered Ernest immolates himself. Finally, Ernest's servant knocks Devet out and buries him alive. How are we getting through this? Maybe like the mother nun character helps us, which I don't know why, but I can't think of any other person who would be aware of his existence and, like, you know, like, I need air. Oh, his darkness. This is intense. All is cold. All is silence. This breathing and stuff is making me even more anxious. We figuring out how to get out? Are we about to lose air? Hey. It's just gonna cut like that? Excuse me? I mean... But... I have so many questions, but I want to listen to the music. Oh, I love it. It's just way too much suspense. It was a little too cut for me to see him bursting from the casket to suddenly the opening music. Can we get back to why the heck you just burst out of the casket, please? Excuse me. We were just bursting out of the casket like 2 seconds prior of that music. You can't trick me with your music trickery. But okay, apparently we're in some wintertime. I don't know, like, we have, like, our eyes covering. What's up? What is going on? Where are we adventuring to? Like, are we reliving experience? Okay. Jeremiah, we must talk. Of your mother deceased, arrangements have been made regarding your upbringing. A man of my position and responsibility can't take the time to look after a young boy. Simple, you don't have time management skills, or you're dealing with grief in a very distant way. Family therapy would have been a good thing instead of sending your child off to potentially summoning otherworldly gods. But hey, all whatever floats your boat. First thing in the morning. Oh dang, you do it like right then and there. You will depart to Scotland. I am sending you to study at the St. Gall boarding school in Aberdeen. You need not bother to write. I will not have time to read your letters. Well, damn. Very cold. You're not even going to read letters your son's gonna write to you? Gosh, you had a lonely childhood. Clearly you needed your friends. So what the heck, we're just getting random flashbacks that were in the abyss of some forest? Okay. But I'm liking the ambiance we're getting. Still no letters for you, Devette. Please, do not persist any further. Fucking he didn't write him back either. Oy. We barely even know this character, and I feel bad for him. Life experience he's had, where he's just wants to live, have a good life, have some friends, maybe have a good relationship with his father. And obviously his mother's gone. Pleased to meet you, my new classmates. And who was that? Oh, that's just Devet. Damn, no mind. He's a little odd. It's Tisk on you. Interesting. Well, see, he's like, odd? Sign me up. Hello, I'm Anthony. Anthony Beechworth. This is my first term here. I've only just arrived. I like your oddball style. Hey, my face is itchy. Hang on. Do 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 do. I mean, both this music sounds sad and somber, but even kind of a travel down memories that have occurred in his past. I hope we can be friends. Aww. Then again, is this him experiences flashbacks, the flashes before his eyes before he potentially dies because he's suffocating? Maybe. What is this rumbling in the background as well? It could be the eye of the bird thing. Oh no, no. We're back here. Which is that bunch of blood underneath us? What is happening? A ticket. I guess a shiver runs down my spine when I look at what could have been my eternal deathbed. Another thing to note, your skin actually looks a little pale. So I don't know. Have you already died, or is it just because you were so afraid? I don't know. I see something else. Do we want to make note of the blood that's on the floor? No? Okay, I guess we're going to look at the poster instead. Just pounding, I feel so weak and thirsty. I don't drink any water soon, I will faint. My dear lord, where am I? That's another concerning bit. You're saying you're tired, you're thirsty, so how are you in this coffin here when we last saw you? You were being buried alive. Something else is going on here. Anything else to inspect, I guess? Through the door? Oh no. Eyes close, ears muffle, voices hush. In the land that loves silence. Eerie. Can I use the ticket on here? Nope, deny. Nowhere else, I guess. Venture forth as we struggle. Are we in some kind of basement? I mean, we already saw what the other basement looked like. It was covered in bodies, so. Hello, please don't try to murder me. Anything to inspect here? No? Guess we're just making our way, walking around, looking at the darkness. Ew. I'm getting really concerned. We have yet to meet anyone else. Please tell me no one, like, walks through a door or something. Oh, this is making me anxious. You're in an entirely different place since we last left off. Are you still dreaming?
I don't know.
Okay. I'm in a city. Is this Aberdeen? How could I have escaped?
Yeah, like, I don't know.
Can't see anything beyond this wall. The dark facades of buildings on the far side.
Okay.
Yes. Keep trudging along, being super confused.
Cheapest potatoes in town.
Little boy, can you help me out? Young man, could you please tell me where I am? Your ghost. Not responding to me. We already died. That's what I'm to assume. Good sir, selling the potatoes. Please, sir, could you give me some water? This ain't a charity talk. I only sell to paying customers, so cough it up or get out.
How about the ticket? Ticket for you?
Oh. Four witnesses. Only one of them's cut out. But technically, shouldn't two be cut out because Anthony and Father Ernest have died? I mean, there is a chance that Father Ernest is not actually dead because sometimes when you burn yourself alive, you don't actually die.
Hmm? Still.
I wonder how this got into my pocket. A ticket to see a play called The Four Witnesses. Why is there a bubble down there? Or is it just meaning that?
Watercress for sale!
Oh no, I think that just counts for you. Yeah, yes.
Our lovely little time in this village that somehow we've appeared in where children won't talk to us, but crabby salesmen will.
Unless, of course, he just doesn't want to talk to us. I mean,
he has his boundaries. He doesn't want to speak to strangers.
And an ignorant in ragged clothing sits leaning against the brickwork. You don't want to talk to him? There's a cart blocking the alley. I won't be able to pass until it's been moved. You one of the puzzles to solve. Making our way. Is that something I can grab? No? A young man sleeps under a filthy blanket. A young woman suffers difficult breathing. Anyone know where I can find this play, or maybe some water? Who's this? Hello? Please, I need water.
Get out of here, I'm drunk.
So rude, everyone. I just need basic life equivalents. Horse meat? Why in the world are they saying oiled in again? If nothing else is to eat, a horse would be something that you could acquire, but that's some desperate times. But there's a man staring at me from amidst the crowd. Something in his countenance seems strange to me. Well, I would like to talk to the belle of the ball. Where are you going?
Please, ma'am, could you tell me where I am? You don't know where you're at? Why, this is old Nicholas Streak, rookie. A darker, more deceptive place like never there was. But that's London. How could I have arrived in this slum? Why can't we go through that door now? Because the weirdo decided to dip off. I guess we're going that way then. Bye, everybody. Got things to do. Potentially something? From the pipe flows grimy water full of soot. What's here? The stench of this sewer drain is nauseating. Wait. Oh, it's a stairs as well. Gotcha. I was like, why are you telling me I can go somewhere? I guess we can climb over buildings? Oh. Well, you need water. No one's providing it. You may get diarrhea, but hey, you get to drink. The water's foul odor is repulsive, but I'm overcome with thirst. We feel a little bit better. You want to take some more? I don't intend to drink that again. It had an awful taste. Well, I guess, do we go back? Because I don't see anything else here I can travel around to. If anything... Oh, never mind. I guess we're just gonna... Don't drink the water. Oh shit, no one even came by. Well, I must have fainted. It's dangerous to be an old Nicholas at night. Should make my way out as quickly as possible. You're already late. It's night. Want to investigate it again? Maybe check out that? I guess head out into the plaza. Oh boy. Everything's super quiet. Nothing here. I guess we're gonna go back over here. Just walking around, seeing if there's anybody here. Hopefully no one tries to stab me. There's weird clouds. Weird clouds indicate weird shit's about to happen. Hello? Hello? Oh, but the cart is out of the way, so now we can go that way. Okay. Easy. Oh. Who's this? Is this our father?
Dr. Wexford is here to see you, mister. Mind her?
Showman hurts.
Is it about your patient, is it not? Oh, right, because the psychiatrist that we talked to at the start of episode 2.
So, is there something else going on, too?
Ah. We were scheduled to show up, but there is no trace of him.
He hasn't shown up for his last few sessions. I've been to his house, of course. His landlady assures me he went on a trip weeks ago and hasn't come back home. He kept the destination to himself.
Then it is happening as I feared.
You got something involved in this?
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, my dear friend. I first thought of this when you described your sessions with her divot. I didn't want to upset you without need as I hoped for the best. Now I'm afraid my suspicions could be true. There are some things that I'll have to verify first, though. I promise that I'll contact you as soon as I have learned anything important.
Being vague and clearly talking about some underlying plot.
Please, her doctor, it is of the utmost importance. No one else knows about this manner.
Probably to eliminate him.
You have my total discretion.
That's your problem. You messed up. You didn't let anyone else know.
Okay. Episode 3.
The Four Witnesses.
Ooh, what a lovely sound.
I feel like I've been walking these streets for hours. Surely I must be close to finding my way out of this labyrinth.
Well, we have eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Let's go up the stairs. I mean, that, I assume. Oh, people hate the mystery man.
Should I be following you? Actually, let me not follow you yet. I like to explore.
Do you hear them? It's the crows. Searching for the moans of the weak and dying. They're calling to each other. They must have found something. Could you help me? Weird man, I must go. Could you help me?
These streets are so confusing to navigate. I'm afraid I've lost my way. Could you direct me out?
Yes, lost one. I can give you direction. I've been gifted with the second sight. I can peer deep into your past and unwind the tapestry of your fate. Do you like me to close my eyes so that yours may be opened?
I haven't a penny to pay you. I don't believe. After the crazy stuff you've seen of it, I think you will believe. I mean, we don't have money.
I haven't a penny to pay you.
Oh dang, why'd the thrilling music start?
Money is no matter here. Come close to me now.
Ooh, we get to play a row of cards. Where to go? What to pick? Find it. That corner.
The mask. The eyes stare at you, and a voiceless mouth calls you. Its lips twist and snarl, and what has seen, what is still to be seen. You think it's a stranger's face, but it is your own.
Where next?
Top. The scream. It begs you to escape. Mute, it shrieks your lost name. Sharp, painful, and burning. Its voice is one you know.
So I'm feeling like maybe this is getting into the tragedy zone where we could have prevented our demise, but you never know.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe, catch a tiger by the toe. Eeny, eeny, picky, 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 buck.
Threads hang from its immense hand of dust, converge upon a single point, your mind, where memories, oblivions, and shadows cluster as one. It is your friend and foe, your home and your prison. Ooh, I'm loving how this is describing. Wait. I don't get to have more cards. Do I get more cards? Please, please. I was having fun with that. I don't understand. What does this all mean? Clearly some other things are at work. I cannot unpick these. The threads you have woven in destiny are too tight, child. But you will. Oh, yes, you will. It is not for me to say, but for you to discover. Remember that in the fog, we see only what is closest to us. The bird remains in the distance. If you wish to leave, you must follow the path of the bird. No more directions can I give. So to follow the weird man or not to follow the weird man? I mean, ask about him. I'm following a man. He must have passed this way. Of course, we literally just walked by him. And how is that man? Well, tall, well-dressed, red hair, and a cold look in his eyes. The nightmare of which we don't talk about. All of us, asleep or awake, have seen that man at some time. Are we talking about the Grim Reaper? I guess I must go. Pardon me. You will need a map to guide your steps. Farewell.
Well.
Could go that way. I could go back. I mean, I'm curious. Let's just say I want to fiddle around different places, okay? The boarded up window is a rundown house. Dust smears the glass, preventing me from seeing the interior. I see a door. Ha ha ha. What will we find behind it? Probably nothing. Well, I did not expect that. Okay. Hi, meat factory that has flies and things upon everything. Cuts of rancid meat lie discarded on the butcher's block. Obviously, this is before the time of food safety and regulation. Let's just venture forth inside. Don't mind me. The fuck is that? The fuck is that? The fuck is that? I'm just gonna scoot myself a little. The remains of a horse hang by a hook affixed to the wall. Its blood drains, seeping into the floorboards. A metal plate is planted in the wall. If I didn't know better, I would say it was a bolt hole. I don't know what a bolt hole is. Candles? Oh! Aha! I figured out the puzzle and I didn't even have to do anything.
I'm intelligent with my puzzles.
Let's scurry inside. Hello. Rusted out drums, empty. This machine is old and in disrepair. It appears to be some sort of filtering machine. Despite its condition, it seems to have been used just recently, which I have no idea what this machine is. Okay, yeah. I see a bottle, a glass, essence there. Liquids are poured into the top and then impurities removed through the valve at the bottom. Okay. Oh, we might have to come back to this later. I mean, some kind of puzzle use for that. Gotcha. A bottle of gin. Oh, but it's empty. Oh. But it may have some uses.
Yeah, yeah. Glass bottle.
Excellent. We have a nice little bottle. Does not look like I have anything else here right now. Let me just crawl out and meet with the meat and travel out somewhere else, okay? Hum, hum, our little spotlight. The street lamp tries to put some light unto the gloom. Well, continuing forth. Do, 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 do. What are we gonna find today? To that corner. I'm just gonna scoot myself a little bit closer. See, we have a window we can be a creep and look into. Glass is fogged over, but a handprint left on the surface. Door? Ah, but it's closed, rats. Down the creepy alleyway we go. I'm guessing the labyrinth leads us back here? So, can I just ignore you, or do I need to talk to you? And I just entirely... Okay, I can entirely ignore you. Well, who wants to go in a sewer?
Oh boy.
That's looking a little scary with the words rats on the wall. Alright. Let's look at this fine art. The letters seem to be inscribed with an oily grime. It reads rats. I'm not sure if it's a warning or an exclamation. Bro, we already know rats are here. It's the thing is it killer rats like from Plague Tale? The sewers flood here with ankle-deep pool of water. Patches of oil swirl. I mean, yeah, oil, icky, it stinks, but at least it's not fecal matter. Is there anything else to explore into? Ah, but we have a bottle! Let's get some quality sewer water. Like some of the oily water. Oh, because then we can filter it. Ew, I see. But would I really trust it? Probably not. Because, I mean, that machine didn't seem like it was up to date. But let's just go head back there and purify our old oily water. What's here? It's just rubbish. Rotted scraps of food and discarded papers. Well, let's go. Which way do we need to go? This way, in order to get to the scary meat plant, in order to distill the liquids, and me not to itch my fingers into oblivion. Hi, everybody. How are you hanging? I'm just gonna go back here. Don't mind me. And I'm fiddle with my hair for the 8th millionth time. Okay. To the oily water bits. Which I'm assuming I just take this, pop you in, I pour the contents of the bottle into the essencer. The oil floats on the surface. When I open the valve, I will drain the water until all the water has been removed. Bro, that was super loud. I've extracted all the water. Only now the oil remains. So did you drink the water or what? Or just keeping the oil here for some other purpose? I already read the ticket.
You okay?
You want me to somehow turn it on? Because we put oil in there, but... Okay, maybe that was it for that puzzle? I don't know. We're gonna continue forth. Maybe we don't have to come back to this meat cellar again? Was there anywhere else to explore before we start going and chasing after Creepy Dude? Which, we really don't even have any information on Creepy Dude besides him just existing. Well, there was this area I hadn't ventured into yet. I'm concerned. I'm just gonna turn back around. And let's... I mean... Let's just go follow after a person. You're up there now. What are you doing, dude? You're freaking me out. Like, you're... hailing me. Okay, are you trying to lead me some specific way? Well, the door now opens, so I guess we're going in. Eh, it's really dark. Hello? I don't dare go on. Oh, because then if we have oil, we can make a torch. Maybe that's what he wants me to do? So I guess venturing the ghostly fog? Hello? Wind is gusting. Apparently we can hear the sea. I'm really freaking out. Seriously, is something to kind of come eat us or something? And we're gonna keep venturing. Until we can't venture further. Oh my god, there's so many noises. Where else? Oh, that just... Ah, I got lost in the fog. If I'm to make my way through, I will need to orient myself somehow. Compass? Okay, we'll keep that in mind. Let's see. Huh, what else could I venture into? I mean, there's a handprint. I don't think I can go talk to you again. There's a sewer. Which I'm assuming there's nothing else for me to grab. Don't think I can enter into this door. Nothing else to adventure these sides. Unless I can grab something. No. It has a posting above it. You may keep your miserable kingdom, you may keep your spike-encrusted jewels. Stay there as you will and stare. Into my eyes, I am a shadow's shadow and will not disappoint. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go adventuring, figuring out what is the next move, the next place I need to travel on to. Can we talk to you? Ah! A rusty old oil lamp sits empty in the corner. No, it does not belong to anybody. You're welcome to take it if you like. I'm not sure what good it'll do without any oil, though. Hit it already.
Yoink.
And let's go back downstairs and grab my oil. And that means I have to go back into that meat plant again. I feel a little tiny burp. Better. And now, I venture through you once more and grab my oil. We can see what else goes down here. And plunk that. Do I need to get any fire? I filled the lamp with oil. I hope it'll be enough to last the night. Maybe you don't even last through the night. That's a big old question mark. Why'd I say it that way? Anyways, hold on. Filling up the oil lamp. Do I have to just activate it? Or assume now we can just proceed onwards. Just a little eerie that there's no noise when we go into this building. Then again, it's supposed to be nighttime. No one's supposed to be here. It still just unnerves me that there's not even music playing in the background. So we need to go to the right. Ah, there we go. There's the creepy music back. I don't think we can investigate the fog with the lantern, but we can go in here. Do I just activate on my person? So, do I need to go fire up the lantern first and then we can use it? I guess so. Which I don't know why we couldn't just have done that in the first place, but eh. To be. Okay, there we go. Now we can use the lantern. Gotcha. Can I move this where it is? Good point. I should be able to hide that. That way it's easier to see. Okay, that makes it a lot easier to function. Now off to see the creepy person, whoever that is. Pardon me, burps. Into the spookiness! Ah, now we can walk forward. Seems a shelter of some kind. That just broken apart. A chest? Oh, an old bottle of St. Elmen's Grand Cru is covered with dust. Oh, we don't want to take it? Check the door? Eh, we can explore. I don't want to venture too far. I want to go upstairs first. No, I want to go upstairs. Let's see what's up there. Oh, there's laughter. I'm getting creeped. Okay, let's just go in here. Oh. Now my eyes focus in the gloom. I can see that the person sitting on the bed is an elderly woman. She's dressed up as a young girl for some reason. She appears not to hear nor see me from here. I'll need to get closer if I'm to explain myself. Yeah, hi. My reflection stares back at me through the grime. An old wardrobe. Photos. A beautiful young dancer. Lovely little fireplace. Don't stick your hand in there, please. Oh, I can't put my hand in there. I'll burn myself. Good job. Hello. Oh, I don't want to dance and sing anymore. That's enough for today. I want my lemonade. I want to play. La 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 la.
Okay.
Besides you being a weird lady, let's talk about the weird man. What? Who are you? Actually, madam, I'm afraid I've never met you before. I don't know who you are.
I don't recognize me?
I don't, I'm sorry. No, ma'am, I'm afraid I do not. I'm very sorry. No, not at all. It's fine. It's been a while since I last performed. I suppose you don't get to forget. I am the great little Castile, singer, dancer, the golden girl of London's music halls. Dementia, maybe? I want to get out of this place. How do I leave? Hide and seek. Oh, I do love games. I go into the fog when I want to get away. Daddy won't find me there, you see. In the fog, there is no faces. So, besides that, how about the weird man? I'm looking for a gentleman. He's well-dressed with red hair. Do you know him? He led me to this place. No, Father, I've been practicing the latest repertoire as you ordered. I've behaved very well today, haven't I? Yeah, you're losing track of reality.
Let's play.
You're gonna run off.
Now stand next to the fireplace and count to three.
Can I pick up this? March 8, 1843. I'm exhausted. Father made me rehearse today for 8 hours. By the end, the music wavered with his trembling hands. Still a long time for the day of the show, but he insisted that everything must be perfect. One more song, he said, over and over. March 21st of 1843. Father got really mad at me and he started to shout when, after many hours of rehearsal, I said I wanted to get out and play a bit in the street. More and more, he's obsessed with rehearsing, with concerts, with perfection. He lost sight that he was raising his child. Oof. April 3rd, 1843. Am I not the one who earns the money to feed us? Am I not the one people come over to see and admire? Is my name not the one printed on all the posters? My name. The dolls for sale at the theater entrance. They have my likeness, my dress, my beautiful hair. I should be the one making the decisions. April 21st of 1843. Things freaking escalated from March to April. One more song. Yes. One more. One last song for you, Papa. Okay, I'm a little scared, but I guess we're gonna go over here. Well, we're not doing that. We're counting to three.
One, a two, a three.
Wait, I thought we were playing hide and seek. This is an entirely different game.
What's the time, Mr. Fox?
Oh, are we... that was... You really threw me for a loop. I actually felt my heart come out. And we're just gonna keep getting closer and closer. One, two, three. What's the time, Mr. Wolf? Okay. Progressively getting further and further into the insanity, the instability. The footsteps are creeping me out. What's the time, Mr. Wolf?
Okay, that was terrifying. Well,
one more song. Ba-ba. Well, I mean, he took the risk of being overly obsessive and he ended up creating a monster.
We're gonna close our eyes and...
Oh, God. Thought we were gonna turn around one more time. She was gonna be like, meh. Okay. Well, and the blazes just happened. Yeah, what the blazes just happened? My head. Ooh, it's pounding. Where did she go? What's this? Oh, a pile of things are on the floor after Fatia's disappearance. Here's a mask. Isn't that a mask that's on, like, one of the covers for the game? I swear I've seen it for, like, the season 2 of this, but... Why on earth is it cracked like this? Split down the middle, one eye is bleeding. Bold red lips and gold face. I don't know the symbolism, but it's eerie. It's a porcelain mask. It broke when it fell. The distorted features. There's a grotesqueness to them. I don't like the look of it. Ooh, a photography. A photograph.
Papa, papa, look at me dance, look at me sing, look at me take your life.
Little catty show. There's a girl lit up by spotlight in the music hall, singing to live piano. So then in turn, by him forcing her to play more and more, he would keep his success too, because, I mean, if he's the one keeping the reins on her, he's the one who controls how much things cost, where they go.
Bunch of manipulations.
Oh, we get to keep the mask. Odami? No. Can I scoop out the fireplace? No. Okay, fine, fine. And that was worth the papers. Wait, don't read it again. We already read it. Click on the wardrobe. It's locked. Ooh, something's in there. How much to bet that it's the old papa in there? I mean, they didn't mention anything about smell. My reflection? I guess. Venture over to where the screw laughter is. The sitter is a strikingly beautiful woman. Her features are sharp and aristocratic as the distant laughter keeps coming up. Let's just go up instead. That's a really big bird cage. If it is for birds. And there's a piano up here. Oh! Oh, this is where Papa had his last song. Looks like the lyrics to a song entitled Last Song for You. The verses are scrawled so poorly as to make them illegible. You want me to play it on this? Oh, this piano is so dusty, I dare say it hasn't been played in years. I wonder if it still works. I guess check out the birdcage. Only feathers. I mean, it's a possibility because, I mean, the reality is a lot of exotic pets being brought over from other countries and then being confined to little cages. But if only a feather remains, that sounds like a clue. You can't... Boy, you have arms. There is plenty of space for you to grab in. Don't say you can't reach it from here. Oh, can I play the piano? Oh, something is preventing one of the keys from depressing. Use the mask? No? Okay, well... I guess we can't figure out the puzzle right now. We'll deal with the creepy laughter then. So the laughter's in there. It's over here. Second violin bar two. Is this supposed to be Papa? But he's playing a piano. Do we have to take the little scrimmy thing? Painting of a beautiful lady with a peaceful expression. She looks like Raphael's angels. So hi. No. Did I not pray enough? Have I not written faithfully every last note you screwed into me? Middle C up to A, measure G up to C, tied F, second violin bar 2, middle C up to A, double note E, G, C. No, this was supposed to be our masterpiece. Viola C up to an octave and then up to a G. What, who do you think you are? Are you blind, man? Can you say that I'm creating the angel's voice? The work, C to A, an octave higher. Android voice flutters from the strophe. No. Hands, swallow you, laugh at you. Lost again. Hey, alright? Do you need some help? Maybe a glass of water would help you. Maybe some sunshine? My inspiration, too, is lost. Quite lost. In the fog, the notes moan, just her. What happened to her? It was very delicate, like a flower in the desert, like a petal in the storm. The sickness, it just swept her away. Her voice, my God. Her voice, it came from heaven. She was the angel of my music. That cue's the perfect inspiration. Even though it's a problematic and toxic movie, Phantom of the Opera just fuels my fire for the musical theater. Just like Hamilton, I mean, they both are good in the musical sense. Back to the game. Who was she, your angel of your music? Oh, beautiful Daphne, the best soloist that a composer could have, the voice of an angel, what made my music possible. She would stand there by the window. The wind caressed her cheeks. It danced in her golden hair. Her dress glowed like an ember in the dusk sun. I mean, from that perspective, dang, you had a goddess. Anyways, besides that, have you seen a weird man? I'm following a man, though come to think of it, maybe he's following me? He has a red beard and wears a cape. You're describing him differently now. You described him as a well-dressed, tall, red-headed man before. And then you decided to drop the well-dressed and tall part. And now you're saying he has a red beard and wears a cape. Why are we mixing up the descriptions all of a sudden? I sometimes find this man too among my notes. I feel him close to me at all times. Feels like we're talking about the Grim Reaper. Because what? This is all based in Scotland, so a different perspective of characters. It could go hand in hand, maybe. But anyways, can we ask more about this? As though what happened to her disappeared, but this is still available. No, I guess. How do you get out of here?
Please, I need to get out.
You ask me for words, but words are betrayers. They are dirty. Music, just music, remains beautiful. It is a prisoner inside all of us. We must set it free. I can't help you now, not until my work is finished. My work is the most important thing. She was my only inspiration. Feels like we gotta give you some new inspiration, or, you know, maybe become a necromancer and summer back from the dead. It's just usual business. My eye is so flickety-giddy-giddy-giddy. Eh. Well, I must go. Should I put more lotion? I mean, that would be a smart thing to do.
Let music and singing surround you, my man.
I guess peer out to the window. A tailor's mannequin. Why is it beside the window? Maybe if we get some hair, some outfits, we could make it pretend. Paper bound up in a roll. Seems to be discarded musical score. Anything else? The wallpaper is torn. Well, goodbye, sir. I guess deal with the laughter. Oh, we can't even go in the room. The doorknob's missing. I guess maybe go back downstairs? I mean, we are missing the little girl. Is there anything here? Bright meadow. Little girl, where are you? Guess venture out into the garden then. Mold covers the wood stacked in the shed. Judging by the resin oozing from the surface, it has appeared to have been chopped down recently. Okay. The resin is thick and sticky liquid. I can't just pick it up with my hands. So we need to find another container. Could we use the mask? No? Okay. Well, what's over here? Do I really have to go in here? Oh, you can't even move it. Never mind. I see a hole on the top. Oh. Mausoleum, where you put dead bodies? I don't want to go in there, but it's crumbled from the age, but it has a hole. Can't we walk up there and just jump in? No? Yeah, I guess. We have a ticket, we have a mask. What other thing could we figure out to do now? We have a coat hanger. It's a pair of gloves. Gloves, the fire, right. I forgot about that because they're like, no, heavens, we can't touch the fire. We will burn ourselves. Now we can go and take care of that, whatever's in the fire. Maybe it's the poker. So use the gloves, and we can come over here. Oh, the doorknob. A spherical piece of metal. Okay, so now we can finish up on that little mission. And we can come down this way. To the creepy laughter in the distance. Hello, whoever's behind this door. This is so effing uncomfortable. You know horror movies. You know when there is the shower curtain scene. Don't crack it. Brave little chicken will keep me safe. Okay? Into the shower room we go. Laughter is coming from behind the curtain. I can faintly see the outline of a figure on the other side. Well, get over there. What the fuck? Huh? Why did you have to make me feel so uncomfortable? I mean, you can't quite see it, but pretty much this. There's a record player, that. Okay, super uncomfy you had to make me feel for what? For what? It's a porcelain doll with lifelike proportions. The face has been removed, leaving her featureless. But its wig shines. Brightly as though human hair. Take the wig. The doll is even more unsettling. Scratched. It's repeating on loop. Maybe check out the window. Covered in dust. I can't recognize my face though. Wooden planks block the window. I can only see part of the outdoors. Anything else to inspect in here? Do you want me to mess with that? Oh, we can make it stop. Cool. Well, I can send that wig over to the violin player. That's something, at least. Plop you down on that. Ooh. Sorry, I didn't mean to put the wig on. Oh, you have to repair it. How can I repair it, though? The resin? That's what I would assume we could do. Score. Huh. What else could I be missing? Because there's nothing else in the bathroom to mess with. Can't use it here quite yet. I mean, oh, it's really gonna have me. If I blow through the paper roll, I can manage to make it fly. I was just clicking on things and apparently it was actually gonna work. Okay. I caught it. A big black feather with some gray spots on the base. What the heck am I gonna use a feather for? Hey, my eye. Could I use the feather to clean it out? Oh, I was literally supposed to click on it. There's a key hidden. There was a key hidden underneath the key. Small key. What else do I need to unlock? Did I come across any other doors that were locked? I think yes, but I can't remember. But I should wait. Can I play now? Oh, nothing happens? Okay. A feather. A key. Where else should I be exploring then? Oh, the wardrobe, right. The fuck is that? Oh, an elegant scarlet party dress. We're going to dress up the mannequin a bit more. Nothing else? Okay, well, let's go bedazzle up that little mask. Or not mask, the... Ugh. If I can get a stupid eyelash to come out of my head and stop tickling my eyes, that'd be great! Let's go dress it up a bit more. Ah, yes, just right. It looks more and more like the young lady in the painting. Anything you want to comment about? No. Oh, how about the mausoleum? Is that where the fiend is buried? That's right. I've a visitor many a nights and have even slept behind her in the cold, wet stone floor. Dedication. Dedication. Well, I must go. So we need to figure out how to get into the mausoleum then. Ticket, a lantern, a broken mask. A creepy little girl who suddenly disappeared. So I'm guessing I need to venture off somewhere else, perhaps? Going outside. I would assume we could use the mask to pick up some of the resin so we could use it. We can't use it. No, okay. Let me try the feather. Oh, okay, apparently I was correct. I managed to coat the feather with the resin. Combine resin with this. I've stuck the pieces together with the resin. The face. It reminds me of a girl of one of those paintings. Interesting. Now, can we look at it? I'm sure I've seen this face somewhere before. Well, let's go back upstairs and we will swoon the poor composer into creating a masterpiece for his beloved dead inspiration. Oh yeah, wasn't there a thing I could double click? Yeah, right, there is a double click. I totally forgot about that. That could make things a lot faster for me. Any day now. And plop that on there, and we will have our finished piece. Daphne, you're back? Are you a figment of my melancholy mind? Are you the ghost of my dying music? No, 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 it doesn't matter, because you're with me again now. I know exactly how to compose my masterpiece. Please take my violin. Now that I've completed my work, I no longer have use for it. It needs to be with her. Go to the mausoleum and place the violin where her heart lies. Angel, my music will guide you. Here, take the key to the mausoleum, my friend. Well, I must go have fun with your little mannequin. Look for Sigmar. Molto agos. First violin crochet. Middle note raised to B to F. Sudden violin double note F to G. Viola's clef. Four tempo silence. Some hands are raising you. You get to the voice. Okay, and we're gonna go venture off. Oh, but we get to hear new music now. Sure, there's been a few jump scares, but this part of the game has been I can't say it, because I mean, we literally discovered that this lady is reliving her past and murdered father, too. I don't know. Still, there's some interesting things going about. I have a key. And into the... what is this? This looks like dirt on the floor. Why does it look like it's been dragged to the depths of hell? Their sarcophagus is broken. Bro, it is broken and dragged through. What on earth is this coffin? Who could have done this? Do you want me to still put the violin here? I was asked to leave the violin close to Daphne's heart, but she isn't here anymore. So I guess we're gonna go look for Daphne wherever she is. The trail of soil leads from the sarcophagus to this hole. Was the coffin transported through here? Okay, time to adventure. What is going on? Why did this poor body get dragged away? Okay, I can't go in there. I can't see anything through these dirty window panes. Assume and just go forward. Can we not? Please? No, don't put your face next to the keyhole. I still remember. What was it? Something, either it was a sequel of One Missed Call or something, where literally someone died when they were looking through what, like, the peephole. God. Wings. Darkness and nothing more. Fuck, I thought I was gonna jump. Spaghetti me. Do you want me to look again? You game. I didn't figure it was actually gonna do something, and you do this to me. Give me a moment to compose myself. Do I want to go in the building? Can I just go venture over here instead? Two directions. I don't know which way to pick. Would this be... Well, no, I don't think it'll even save right now, so I have to venture forth. I'm absolutely terrified of going that way, but... I'm curious of where the coffin went. Go the scarier way. Okay, hi, whatever's in here. Oh, it's dark. Help of river, the nutty Daphne hid from sun in the shadowy mist. She changed her skin for strong bark, so her heart was forever concealed, her dance frozen in the rustle of a thousand leaves. I mean, in a way, are you talking about her becoming decomposed, or... turning into something else? Okay, well, I'm gonna venture forth with all these books. Old forgotten languages. Books with unpronounceable names in dead languages. Whatever else could we be finding here? Myths and legends this time. Norse tales, Greek, ancient Sumerian, others I don't recognize. Some of these. Scripts I've never seen. See, told you, at the very start of the game, cults. Cults were going to be heavily prevalent in this. And another room. Whatever could we find in the mysterious darkness? Who the fuck is that? Good day, sir. I'm gonna say hello. I beg your pardon, sir, if I've startled you. Yeah, you. Were you the one staring at me earlier? What are you doing here in the dark? Why? How are you reading them? You're reading these marvelous books in pitch black darkness? In the dark? How can you see the words without any light whatsoever? That is the only way to see them, really. That is, if you want to see the world on the other side of the page. The words from the shadows. Shadow always hides from the light, you know. So they can only be read in darkness. Take a moment. That does, on one turn, sound super hella creepy and creepy scary. And the other part sounds freaking edgy emo kid logic. Are you the owner of this bookstore? Oh goodness no, the bookstore doesn't belong to anyone. Not since I found it here. I'm just a guest, an explorer of these ancient tombs. Tombs? Why did I say tombs? I mean tomes. How about the weird man we talked about earlier? Now you said red hair tall and a cape. Again, changing up different descriptors you're using. Oh yes, I know of whom you speak. I see him here to time, perusing the books. You pick one off the shelf, glance at it, and put it back. He and I have never spoke, though. Why do you ask? Well, I mean, it seems like he's been watching me. Guiding? I don't know. Maybe, what books is he perusing? Let me think. Yes. I recall him looking at unexplored places of the Empire. An excellent tome, very revealing and very rare. This bookshop is very fortunate to have a copy in its collection. I'm not sure where it is now, but I'm sure it can't be far. Well, excuse the interruption. Pardon the interruption, sir. I will leave you to your spooky reading. Yes, venture forth to wherever this book is. Yes, further in. Be gone. Stab. Now. On the side note, it's very pretty sounding, but it's hella scary. Like, putting yourself in the shoes of this character with only an oil lamp and just this ominous music just coming out of the darkness. And we've got to continue forward. Is any books going to be clickable so I can find... Oh, something. The book lies on the floor. Hey! The book lies on the floor. Its spine reads unexplored places of the Empire. A page has been marked. Wait, what was the page? Oh, a place of eternal fog, also known as Zahila. It is a unique bay in the east of Balishwar, near the jungles of Bengla. It's surrounded by tall, snow-capped mountains, usually covered in mist, and the waters of the bay are very dangerous and rarely visited. Why are you telling me about this? I mean, sure, we saw the fog earlier, but How's that going to orient myself? This... What is this? What? What the f- is this? What's further here? A tree? It's a massive dead tree. How could it have formed inside this building and without sunlight? Otherworldly being, it probably feasts on humans. Over here, a body. Oh, the songs of Zahila. The page of which was open has been torn out. But the remaining fragments identify a song title. Search of Samir. Something's over there, too. Oh, a page torn from the book below. Oh, can I take it? Do you need to use the violin? No? Huh. Anything else to click? A window shrouded with a thick layer of dust. Not even a glimmer of light shines through. So the tree's not you? And I'm assuming Lullaby Voice is Daphine as a reanimated corpse? To venture forth into the perils. The music stopped. Why did the music stop? Hello? Who's down here with me? Getting so uncomfortable. Cannot. I feel my just heart going. Be brave. Be brave, okay? Into the darkness. Oh, there's a page. There's a note obscured by mud. I mustn't fall asleep. I hear them crawling. I hear them gnawing. Rats. Too many of them. They know I'm here. I mustn't fall asleep. They stalk me. Coming closer and closer. I can see their blood-red eyes glimmering in the darkness. I mustn't fall asleep. Okay. Oh, a pile of ragged clothes caked with mud. Oh god, did the rats eat this body? You want me to pick anything else? I guess we're gonna venture forth to whatever the heck is in the depths of this area with all these tree roots. The dead roots of a once great tree fill the cavernous sewer. Strange green moss covers its surface, and there is a great crack along its length. Do you want me to go in there? Do we need to break it open? So Daphine became a giant ass tree. We just literally put it inside of her heart. The violin has disappeared amongst the roots, as if swallowed up. The tree, whatever you call the base of the tree, seems to be expanding. A noise comes from above. Okay, well, thanks, Daphine, for helping me out with your creepy lullaby in the darkness and potentially rats that could be living down here. I'm just gonna go back upstairs. Which I'm assuming that's the only place I can go. Is there anything else I should be venturing down here in the darkness?
Don't fall asleep.
Okay. Nothing else? I am so truly terrified of this place. Oh, this converges with the rat area. Was I able to go through that area earlier? I don't remember. Huh. Interesting, terrifying, but I see how all these areas connect now. What will I be able to find up here since whatever cracked open? A surprising lush vegetation covers the place. I don't recognize the species these plants belong to. Sure. I see the steps. The tree has grown. Yeah, some of the branches have crashed through the window and into the street. So, I can grab the photos for now? Intense rays of light stream into the bookshop. That was an elaborate way for me to get that paper, but okay. So we go back in here. So is that other dude gonna mention anything about this tree just bursting forth? Hello. I guess you have nothing else to say. Let's see. Into the darkness, and we head outside. Go this way? Do you want me to go this way then? Which way is the branch is coming out of then? Well, I guess we're supposed to go the other way since we unlocked the latch. Let's just travel back. This way? Fire crackles. You're here. So this isn't the direction I need to go. Back this way? Because I need the song paper, but which direction is that going to crash through? There we go. The paper sheet captured in the tree branches is now within my reach. And a yoink of that. On the page is a strange poem. Burst into the wind, he sought for the king. But lost were the birds, they wept in suffering, and flew into the sea, compelled by a need. They found their silence. Their quest was complete. Hello, dear sir. You just reappeared. I guess we gotta go follow you. Good sir, good sir. We need to talk about your car insurance. You are one tough customer to keep up with. So that may just be directions. First into the wind, they sought for the king. Flew to the sea. I guess just venture forth deeper and deeper into here. Unless I need to find silence. Oh. Ah, there's different entrances. Okay, makes sense now.
2,000 years later.
We have the creepy hand again. Silence, silence. Cicadas. But I don't see any birds cawing. I hear the birds. Did I seriously get myself this tripped up? To the wind, to the birds, and now to the sea. See, this is where I fucked up. I was getting lost on the bird and the seas. So here's that freaking statue. Because the birds are seeking the king. I mean, it sounds silent. Yeah. But now, what's here? Their quest was complete. Hello, can I have my lantern back out? In this foggy abyss. Just making our way through an otherworldly experience. Hello. You just vanished out of existence. Excuse me, sir. You want me to follow you? Your ticket, please.
Why, sure. Here's my ticket for the show.
The four witnesses. Thank you. Please come in.
Gladly. Dirt.
Oh, look, even one of the heads is chopped off. Hey! Oh god, we're looking at this through windows. Oh my god, I feel so creeped. Goodness, I mean, this is very interesting style-wise. Thrilling. Then I just keep wanting to look behind and be like, is something following us?
Find your seat, sir. The show's about to start. Hello, Jeremiah. I know you would find us eventually. Welcome to our humble performance.
You were there. You were part of the group.
You don't remember my name, do you? I am Alexandria.
What is this about? What do you want from me? This is very elaborate to just ask for my help of some kind. From you.
Nothing, dear Jeremiah. It is you who came here searching for answers. It is the same as when you joined our group. We each came with our own reasons.
Do you not remember yours?
I mean,
from what we're detailing from the past, philosophy, I believe. True philosophy. Indeed, it was our thirst for knowledge that drew us together. No one waits for us out there, dear Jeremiah. There is no one who will care for us when our horror comes. We had been alone until now. How did I end up in London after being buried in the boarding school? Like, is someone explain this logic? Are you trying to say I'm undead? Like, I can't be killed? Or are you trying to say I can't be murdered? Because, I mean, that would make sense why Anthony would take his own life, because from that power, he takes it away from the bird, potentially? I mean, it could be, like, his body and soul kind of deal. But anyways, the bird protects us. It is by his design that we should meet again. But we're not the only ones who take shelter beneath his wings. His influence and power is ever expanding, ever reaching. Do you not feel him beckoning? I only want to wake up from this nightmare. Wake me up! This is no nightmare. It's a show, a performance. The truth we seek lies beyond the curtain. Now we have crossed the point of no return. The lights are on, the stage is set, and soon you shall meet the actors. Welcome. Stop. This belongs to you. I can't just leave. Can I go elsewhere? No. This is my only choice. I can't just exit stage left. Then train clacking. Dear is her Dr. Wakefield. If you're reading this, then you have followed my instructions to arrive and agreed upon address. Good. Apologize, I couldn't accompany you immediately. My own investigations have demanded a certain anticipation of attention. I have determined your patient Yvette is in serious trouble. I will contact you with more information post-haste. In the meantime, discretion is of the utmost importance. Your friend, Johann Kaufmann. The truth behind the curtain achievement. Ooh. And next time's episode 4. What the heck is even supposed to happen? I mean, clearly we've gotten ourselves involved in something nefarious. So, back to the main menu. Ominous. Hell ominous, but man. Does this game create such an awesome plot? I'm excited by this. I am ecstatic. I mean, obviously, next time we play this will definitely be live stream edition. So, have a good day. We're gonna have a fun time next time. Bye. Thank you.